The Škoda T27 is the latest premium tank World of Tank Blitz released. And if you looked closely, you may have noticed that the legendary camouflage features a writing on the side of the turret saying Lidis. This is not due to hazard, because it actually has a meaning that I'll tell you today. First of all, what's Lidis? It's a small town located into the south of Czech Republic that suffered a terrible fate. Everything started with two men, Josef Kapsik and Jan Kubis, sorry for the pronunciation, that were both special soldiers during World War II. After the Third Reich started invading eastern countries, and especially Czech Republic, multiple rebellions started to take place and many actions were taken against the Nazis' occupation. But unfortunately, Czech Republic fell easily to the Third Reich because of the lack of supply and help they were expecting to receive from the Allies that never made it. It did not stop our two friends as they flew straight to Great Britain, where they were formed by the British Special Forces in order to perform a secret mission that would change the course of war. Their mission is simple: assassinate Reinhard Heydrich, a former SS Obergruppenführer. He's known for three things. He's the vice governor of Czech Republic at that time, played a huge role in the organization of the Final Solution, namely the Jewish genocide, as well as the repression of political opponents within the Czech Republic. A man responsible for the murder of thousands, from which Josef and Jan wants to get revenge. The plan is simple. Every day, the target must drive from his house to the Chernivtsi Palace, where he works out. It is equal to roughly a 20 km ride. Within this delay, he is quite exposed as the car contains two men only, Reinhard and his driver, which gives a perfect opportunity for a sneaky attack. On the night of December 21st, 1941, three men including Josef and Jan are parachuted behind the enemy lines nearby the road Reinhard is taking every morning. Their goal is to ambush the man and take his life. It is only 6 months after the 27th of May 1942 in the morning that they will put their plan at execution. The soldiers launched a grenade near Heydrich's car, leading it to explode while some parts penetrated Heydrich's body. He's injured but not killed, which will lead the men to think their attack failed. The real killer of Heydrich was nature, as some splinters from the car that penetrated his body led him to die from septicemia. Angered by the death of one of their highest-ranked officers, the Nazis started investigating the men. They offered nearly $500,000 to whoever gave the name of the responsibles, but also an immunity to any sentences. This led the third man of the commando, Karel Kurda, to turn himself in while giving out the name of others, as well as the city they were hiding in. This led to Josef and Jan being circled around their safe house, a church nearby, where they got executed. Karel later joined the Gestapo as a double agent. But what's the link with Lidice? In his testimony, Karel mentioned that the commando hid in Lidice to prepare the attack. It didn't take anything else for the Nazis to prepare their revenge. The 10th of June 1942, an SS division circles the village. They execute all men above the age of 16, take the women, and align the children. There are 105 of them. Out of those, only 10 will be spared for fitting Nazis' physique criteria. The rest are deported and killed in gas chamber. The village is destroyed and all the traces of Nazis' atrocity erased. It was later found out there was no correlation between the commando and the town of Lidice. Lidice and all its inhabitants served as scapegoat.